All right, guys, so let's get into functions. Now, every programming language basically has functions. I mean, they're going to be different depending on which programming language we're discussing. Even COBOL has functions, but they're radically different because that's just an entirely different language. However, basically, if you have any experience with PHP, JavaScript, functions are going to look a lot, very similar. So we are now past the need to use an interpreter, and what we're going to be doing from here on out is using our IDE that we have installed. Again, I want you guys to follow along, maybe even do some extra repetitions of this just to get used to it. So the first lesson here in the subsection of functions is going to be building a function. So, pretty simple. We're going to build a function, we're going to call it, and we're going to run the script. So, let's go ahead and drop down a couple lines. And also, we're going to go over some Pep guidelines throughout this course. We're probably going to have a module specifically for PEP, but as I go along and I see or think of anything that's addressed in the PEP guidelines, I'll let you know. So basically, what PEP is Python's style guide. So it's like how to write certain things and certain, we always drop down two lines between any text or at the top of a script. So we would have our imports up there and then drop down two lines and then start coding. So we drop down two lines and we're gonna, instead of typing function, we're gonna type def. And what this is telling Python is that it's gonna define a function. So we write def and then the name of the function. Now, regarding naming functions, there's a specific way to do it according to the PEP guidelines. This isn't new, this specific instance. It's using snake case for function names. So if you know camel case, that's basically like this, right? That's what that looks like. The first letter of each word is capitalized. That's used in Python for class names, but it's not used for functions. When you define a function in Python, you're encouraged to use snake case, which is separating words with underscores. So that's what we're going to do. So I'm going to create a function here called my function. So basically, so far, we've got def, which says we're about to define a function. We've got the name of our function, and then we've got brackets right here. And these brackets are going to be used for parameters, which we're going to be going over in one of the next videos. They're also called arguments. Now, after we do this, here's the point when in most programming languages you'd open your curly braces and start to code, but instead with Python, where we don't use those curly braces, we just put a colon here. Now, this is going to be smart. I mean, Python's smart because it's going to automatically determine when this function is complete based on indentation. So, based on that, you can probably assume how we're supposed to use this. But we hit enter, you'll notice that it automatically indents four spaces in. And this is because anything four spaces in from the left-hand side, as of right now, is going to be the top level of this function. And then you can further indent stuff, and we're going to explore that as needed as we go on. So this is going to be just a very basic function that prints something out. So let's go ahead and print out, this is my function. And then we come down here, and we remove the indentation, telling the function that we're done. So now anything we write here is not considered inside that function. Now we could additionally put more in this function simply by doing that and writing more indented to the fourth space in. Now also with Python, this isn't something that I've mentioned yet, I don't think, but you don't need to end statements with a semicolon like in a lot of other programming languages. So just keep that in mind. So now we can drop down out of that function. Now we can call that function. So to call a function, you're just gonna type the name of the function And then any parameters that you're going to pass in, which would go in these brackets. In this case, we're not going to put anything in these brackets because we're not passing in arguments. We're going to be going over that in the next video. Now, actually, you can see PEP 8, no new line at end of file, which means we need a new line at the end of file. And you'll see that the issue has been resolved. So PyCharm will kind of let you know if you're ignoring or just not using any PEP guidelines in your code. So let's go ahead and save this and let's go ahead and run. And as you'll see down here in the console, it first printed out, this is my function, and then it printed out a second string. So if we look up here at the code, again, we're going to go over the flow of this one more time. We're defining a function, we're naming the function my function so that we can call it by that name, and we're putting brackets here, which will contain arguments at some point. You don't have to. If your function doesn't take arguments and doesn't need outside information, just don't put anything in there. And then a colon, which starts the indented block of code on the next lines, which is indented 4 spaces. Now, I mentioned further indentation, in a function like 8 spaces, 16 spaces. That's for each block of code. And that's not really something I can explain further. You guys are going to see it as we go on. So anyway, this is the function because they're both indented to 4 lines. So Python knows that's inside the function. And then down here, outside the function, we're calling the function, making it printed out. So in the next video, we're going to talk about arguments and how to use those inside your function.